This video will show you how to degas a sample on the Micromeritics preparation systems, including the FlowPrep, VacPrep, and SmartVacPrep. Remember to always consult your operator's manual for more detailed information. For a physisorption analysis, a sample should be degassed to be clean from any adsorbed contaminants to ensure the accurate measurement. There are two types of degas methods: flowing inert gas, usually nitrogen, over the sample, or pulling a vacuum. A flowing degas system can be faster at removing surface contaminants than a vacuum system. The vacuum degas system has the ability to remove more surface contaminants and is especially useful for microporous materials. The difference in cleanliness is negligible for most non-microporous materials. Focus should be placed on temperature and degas time. The first step in the process is to determine the degas temperature based on the type of material you are working with. For a flow degas, either FlowPrep or VacPrep can be used. For a vacuum degas, either VacPrep or SmartVacPrep can be employed. On the FlowPrep, set the sample tube in the cooling station and turn on the gas. Immerse the tip of the gas delivery tube in water to check the flow of nitrogen gas. Flip the switch at the top of the instrument upwards to allow gas to flow. Bubbles should rise from the gas delivery tube in the water, indicating that gas is flowing. Turn the knob on the top of the probe to adjust the flow. Wipe the tip clean. And insert it into the bottom of the sample tube. Put the sample tube in the heating stations. And change the temperature with the arrow buttons. Once degas time is complete, move the sample tube to the cooling station. Once the sample has cooled, it is ready to be weighed and mounted on your instrument. When using the VacPrep for a flow degas, the process is similar to the FlowPrep. First, set the sample tube in the cooling station and turn on the gas by turning the knob on the instrument upwards toward gas. Then submerge the tip of the gas delivery tube into water to check the flow of gas. Bubbles should rise from the tube, indicating that gas is flowing. Turn the knob at the top of the tube to adjust the flow. Wipe the tip of the tube clean and insert it into the sample tube. Then place the sample tube into the heating station. And change the temperature with the arrow buttons. Once degas time is complete, move the sample to the cooling station. Once cooled, your sample is ready to be weighed and mounted on your instrument. To begin, place the sample tube into the cooling station. Unscrew the nut, ferrule, and O-ring from the sample tube mount. Then place the nut assembly onto the sample tube as shown. And screw into the sample tube mount. Place the tube into the heating station. To begin pulling a vacuum, turn the knob for your desired port downwards toward vac. Adjust the temperature using the arrows on the keypad. As a vacuum is pulled, the gauge should read the decrease in pressure. When the degas process is complete, move the sample to the cooling station and allow to cool. To remove the sample tube mount, we recommend unscrewing the nut and then turning the knob on the instrument from vac to gas. The vacuum will be released and the assembly will pop off. Ensure to place the rubber stopper back on the sample tube. The sample is now ready to be weighed and mounted on your instrument. A SmartVacPrep automates a majority of the degas process, saving you valuable time. Pins should be removed from the sample port if check seals are not used. Check seals are available for 1/2-inch and 12mm sample tubes. A 1/2-inch tube with check seal is used in this demonstration. Place the nut, ferrule, and O-ring on the sample tube. Then place the sample tube in the degas port and tighten the nut to secure. Slide the heating mantle over the sample and use the provided clip to hold it in place. The remainder of this process is done using the Microactive software. To create a sample file, go to the File menu and select New Sample. Select Physical Adsorption as the new sample type. Go to the Degas Conditions tab. From the drop-down menu, a pre-saved degas conditions can be loaded. Whether to backfill the sample tube after degas or wait for operator can be customized. The initial evacuation conditions can also be customized here. Under the heating phase, enter the desired temperature, ramp rate, and time. Save the file. Note the same SMP file can be used for degas and analysis. To start degas, go to the SmartVacPrep menu, Prep, and click on Start Degas. Click Browse to select the SMP file for the appropriate degas port, and click Start. Once completed, a notification will be shown with the SMP file name indicating that degas is finished. The sample can be removed from the SmartVacPrep and mounted on your instrument for analysis. On the SmartVacPrep, there are also lights to indicate the status of degas. The orange light blinks when evacuating and cooling, and the red light when ramping and degassing. Once the sample tube is cooled down, the green light will be on to indicate the degas is complete. This is an option to quick start degas. On the software, go to the SmartVacPrep menu, Prep, and Quick Start Degas Conditions. Click on the Edit for each port to enter desired degas conditions. Save and close the degas conditions. Save and close the quick start window. After loading a sample tube on the desired port, press Select, and once the blue light is on, press Start. Now you are ready to degas a sample for a physadsorption analysis on the Micromeritics preparation systems using the FlowPrep, VacPrep, and SmartVacPrep. For more information, visit micromeritics.com/learn.